MagVent Dryer Vent Man here. Today we're going to be installing a MagVent in a dryer box. People will often ask us, can you install a MagVent in a dryer box? And the answer is yes, it works out good. It saves you a lot of space. The most common MagVent model to go in a dryer box would be the MV-90, because the dryer box is sort of made to vent up or down. And you can use the MV-90 in any of those situations. Today we're going to be using the Dryerbox 350, the DB350. It's a aluminized steel 22 gauge, really heavy duty, makes for a good fire stop. And so we're going to be taking advantage of that. We got a 2x4 wall, pipes already strapped in there pretty good. We should be good to go. They're wanting the dryer vent height to be here. That's about 6 inches center from the floor. That's about standard. And falling right here in the stud bay, it's about 5.5 inches off of this stud. So if we look at, gonna be going in with the dryer box like that, the dryer box hole is about, I'd say, 3.5 inches approximately to its center of the oval. So we're gonna need to push this guy over. It was a 5.5 to 3.5. We gotta go 1.5 inches. Let's call it a 2x4 with a piece of drywall to pack out this stud to get that center right where we want it. Packing this out with a 2x4. Just add that. Give us that extra 1/2 inch. We're just gonna set the dryer box here to, we can catch wood. Looks like we're pretty well centered to drop down there. We'll check our mark in a minute. It's good to, whether installing a dryer box with a MagVent or just the dryer box in general, it's good to be as low down as possible for your standard installations. So we're looking good. So something I wanted to show you real quick, we were able to move this box over because it was a new construction situation by packing out the stud. But sometimes you got a dryer box already installed and where the pipe comes down straight might not line up with where the MV-90 needs to be. So you can use these adjustable elbows in a box to kick it over a little bit to get you where you might need to be. You'd plug that into the existing pipe and then you could kick the 90 over, and you also have a little bit of play that way as far as whatever you need to do to center it up. But we're gonna get back to the install at hand. Trying to see, looks like we're coming in pretty close to center. We can raise it up a bit, we'll be fine. So we've verified that the dryer box is in the position it needs to be. I'm gonna go ahead and fasten it to the wall. So get your MV-90 in position and then mark where its bracket sits. If you get a side and a top corner, you should be pretty good for locating the bracket. And that should do fine. Don't use included 1-inch screws. Use 1/2-inch self-tapping screws instead to avoid penetrating drywall on the backside. Pretty solid installation there. We're just gonna hook the MagVent into place, engaging the tabs in the side. So we're in a 3.5-inch stud bay here. We're gonna have to oval the pipe a little bit to get it to go into the dryer box and get it to fit in the stud bay. There we go. So we're gonna try to round this back out a little bit. And we might have to crush the MV-90 a little bit. Push the pipe down on it until it bottoms out. gets a nice tight seal. We'll give it a tape. So that is one solid install. I feel pretty good about that. I'm loving it. Right, so I'm gonna fire caulk from above while I can get to things real easy. The dryer box is making a good fire stop, but you gotta make sure that you are sealed so that any flames in the event of a dryer fire would not get up into the wall cavity and potentially set the studs on fire. Here's a little trick where it's really hard to get at. You can put some caulk on your finger and get it back there and make a pretty good seal all the way around. Just gonna finish up here. You can see where the caulk from the above caulking came down. So in order to transfer these radii to my drywall, I'm gonna go ahead and mark it on a little cardboard template and then cut the radiuses on that. And then I can transfer them to the drywall real easy. Fill in the rest there. Pull a couple of dimensions real quick. I'm gonna cut a little bit outside of this line. And then we'll test the fit and then transfer it to our drywall. The fit looks pretty good. Got a little slop on the radius. This'll probably be all right. We're gonna be caulking it anyway. We want to make sure it fits on there. So that's what we're going to go with. Let's give it a try. I'm going to cut this out down this straight and across those radii, then I'll break it out. I'm just going to clean up these furry edges from the cut real quick. Give us something a little nicer to caulk around. Go ahead and trim some of this furriness before I caulk. You can use regular caulk here. You could use painter fire caulk if you want. That looks pretty good. We're just gonna do a test fit here with the MagVent, make sure everything's good. It looks like we're about 7/8 of an inch from the very back piece of metal of the dryer. About a dryer cord's thickness away from the wall. So, there you have it. MagVent and dryer box work great together, allowing you to get your dryer extremely close to the wall while maintaining an unrestricted vent path.